Hello everyone, this is Tamala. Welcome back again to Designing with Tamala Bowie Interiors, and I have a great show lined up for you today. In my first segment, I'm going to show you how to bring an upscale, luxurious model home look to your master bedroom space, step by step. I'm also going to show you how to pick paint colors. And in the last segment, I'm going to share with you three items that you'll need to create a luxe look in your home. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into segment one. Okay guys, so I want to share with you some tips on how you can make your master bedroom look like a model home bedroom. So I'm standing in this beautiful master bedroom at Darling Homes. This is a model home. And the first thing you want to start off with when you are wanting to create a model home look in your master bedroom, you always want to start with a sumptuous bed. And of course, we all know that those tufted headboards are in style. And so of course, you see this tufted headboard in this beautiful ivory color linen. Now, another thing you want to do, you want to incorporate sumptuous bedding. And I absolutely love this bedding. It's white bedding that's trimmed in this beautiful cream and beige and gray. And they just simply added in these additional pillows just to give it more of a grand feeling. Now, another thing you can do to make your master bedroom feel like a model home, of course, is to have some sort of bed tray sitting there for decorative purposes. And it can also be for functional purposes as well. Now, the next thing you want to do, you want to incorporate your bedside tables. And designer tip number two, please do not over decorate your nightstands. Reason being, you want to have somewhere to be able to set your glasses or a glass of water or one of your favorite reading books. But if you have overly styled your nightstand, you're not going to be able to have that opportunity. So on this particular nightstand, they incorporated this beautiful lamp and just a picture. Now, designer tip number three, make sure that your lamp is tall enough to provide ample lighting for you to be able to read in bed. And how you can gauge that, you just simply sit up in bed with a book, you place your lamp beside the bed, and then your lamp should shine light directly onto the book. So that's how you'll know if you have the perfect height for your lamp. Now for the wall art, I like how they just simply styled this area of the nightstand with two beautiful canvas prints that incorporates and pulls in the colors in this space, which are the golds, the grays, the creams, and the beige. Now they also duplicated that same look on this side of the bed. The only thing different is that instead of having a picture frame, they just incorporated these two jars. Now you can, in lieu of these jars, you can place some decorative boxes over there that will serve as additional storage. And then again, they just incorporate these two beautiful canvas art prints in those same colors, and they use the same lighting. Now, speaking of lighting, another way that you can create a model home look in your master bedroom, and that is to add in a beautiful chandelier. I love this chandelier because it picks up the golds that's in the space with this aged bronze look. I also love the glass glows because it will allow for more light to shine into the space. And to add that little wow factor, they've added this beautiful crystal ball at the end of the chandelier. Now, for those people that you have to have a ceiling fan in your space, they have what's now called a fandelier, and it's a chandelier and fan combination. And so if you're interested in getting some images or ideas about fandeliers, then just shoot me a quick email and I will be more than happy to share with you some sources for a fandelier. Now let's talk about this window over here. Of course, this master bedroom overlooks a beautiful landscape backyard, and they just kept the window panels very, very, very simple with a gorgeous silver rod, and they have the pinch pleat window panels, and they position the window panels where they're not covering up the window. So whenever you are incorporating window panels into a space, and especially if that space is overlooking a gorgeous landscape view, you don't want to cover up the windows. So you just position the window panels where they're just gracefully covering any type of wall structure that may be there, but they're not covering the windows. Now, you guys know how I always stress creating vignettes in a space. Well, this is a perfect area in the corner of this room to create a resting area where you can come in, sit down, take your shoes off,
or if you just want to sit right here and just enjoy reading a book. And this area was created with just a simple side table and with a nice, comfortable accent chair. Now, the only thing that I would have done differently here, I probably would have placed some sort of floor lamp behind the chair, because you're going to need some task lighting if you're sitting there reading. But other than that, this is a great way to incorporate a sitting vignette in a master bedroom. Now, let's talk about the carpeting in this space. I absolutely love this trefoil pattern that's on this carpet. This gives this bedroom a upper class feeling of class and sophistication. Now, the last thing that I want to share with you guys on how to make your master bedroom look like a model home is the dresser area. And this dresser is directly in front of the bed. And I love the fact that the nightstands and the dressers are not matching. People, please do not buy matching tables and dressers. Just make sure they complement each other in style and in wood color. Now, they kept the decor to a minimum on this dresser. I love that they used this glass box to serve as storage. And also to bring in that wow factor, they've added these two vases on top of the dresser. Now, this mirror, I love the fluid lines of the mirror. And I love the gold, the aged gold in the mirror frame, because it picks up on all the classy and elegance that's throughout the space. Now, I love the fact how they placed a mirror. It also shows or give you a glimpse of the beautiful bed. So, designer tip again, be sure whenever you are decorating or incorporating a mirror into a space that it reflects something beautiful, and it reflects something that you'll be able to get a quick glimpse of. If it's reflecting a ceiling or reflecting something that's not aesthetically pleasing, then try to relocate the mirror to an area where it is reflecting something of beauty.
Okay guys, so now in segment two, I'm going to discuss briefly on how to choose the best paint color for a space in your home. Now, these are the two paint suppliers that I normally use when I'm doing a design or decorating project: Sherwin-Williams and Benjamin Moore. These two suppliers, they have some of the best paint color selections, and their paints are really, really, really good in that they have low VOCs and their quality is the best. Now, with Sherwin-Williams, I love the fact that they have all of their paint colors separated by what you'll typically see on a color wheel. They have the red, orange, the yellow and green, the blue and violet, your neutrals, your historic colors, your timeless, your white and pastels, and also some softer neutrals. And over here in Benjamin Moore, they basically do the same thing as well. So this, having these two kits, make it easy whenever I am going to a client's home to do a paint color consultation, or if we are having to choose a paint color for a design or decorating project. So I just want to just give you some tips on what I do when I'm having to choose a color for a design or decorating project. So now, I'm sure a lot of you guys are probably familiar with this paint sample card, and you'll probably have seen these inside of a Sherwin-Williams store or a Home Depot or Lowe's. And the reason why they have these paint samples on these type of cards is because these colors right here, if you were to use these colors in your home, all and you chose all three of these colors, that your home will flow, because all these colors are complementary to each other. So if, say for instance, you wanted to do your living room in this color, then you can choose this color for the family room, and you can choose this color for the game room, and your house will flow. So sometimes I assist clients with paint consultations when they're wanting me to consult with them or provide a color palette that they want to use throughout their home, or if they're just wanting one particular room painted. This makes it a lot easier picking, coordinating colors. Now, another thing you want to also keep in mind, on the back of some of those paint chip cards, they have what's called a light reflective value. And what that means, that measures the amount of absorbable or visible light that the paint absorbs or reflects. So typically it's on a scale from 0 to 100. 0 meaning that the paint absorbs a lot, and as you get closer to 100, it means that the paint is more reflective. So What that also means is that anything that is reflective, it actually can reflect something lighter. Just like if you place a mirror in a space opposite of a window, it's going to reflect the light more around the space. So if you have a dark room and you want to lighten up the space with paint, you want to choose a paint that has a high light reflective value, because it's going to be reflective more of the light versus one with a low reflective value, because it's going to absorb more of the light. So another thing also you want to keep in mind when you're choosing a paint is the sheen of the paint. The majority of the time, kitchens and bathrooms and hallways, you can get away with a semi-gloss, more so in the bathroom because you're dealing with humidity aspects. So you want the walls not to absorb so much of the moisture. So the majority of the time you want a semi-gloss. In the kitchen, the same way as well. Now, in your bedrooms, in your formal areas, or in your family rooms, you want to go with a satin finish because it's washable and it also bounces light off. The only time I would suggest using a matte finish is on the ceiling, because you don't want the ceiling to be reflective if your wall is also reflective for using the satin. Now, your high gloss or semi-gloss you can also use on crown moldings, on picture frame moldings, and also on your baseboards. So hopefully I've provided you with some great tips on how to choose a paint color for your next design or decorating project. Now, also, I do e-design for paint consultations. So if you're getting ready to embark on painting your house and you need help with choosing a color palette, then you can go ahead and send me an email, and then we can go ahead and schedule for an e-design paint consultation. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this quick tip on how to choose a paint color for your next decorating or design project. Okay guys, so in this last segment, I'm going to share with you my three essential items that you will need to create a luxe look in your space. Now, the first item you're going to need, and that is a splurge. And what a splurge is, that's normally something that you've saved up for because it was so expensive, and now you finally have the money budgeted for it, you go out and you purchase that expensive thing. And typically a splurge is a piece of furniture. It can be an accent chair, just like this beautiful acrylic accent chair from Global Views, or it can be this whimsical, unique sofa that can be a splurge for someone. Or in my case, my splurge was the purchase of this mid-century modern sideboard. I was so excited when I had the opportunity to purchase it, and so that was my splurge for my family room space. Now, the second thing you're going to need, and that is an art sculpture. And the reason why I feel that art sculptures can make a room feel luxe, because you can pick those up from your travels. It helps to tell your personality and character, and also they make great conversation pieces. Now, the third essential item that you would need to create a luxe look in your space, and that's art. And the reason why I think art can be a luxe item is because you can draw your color palette from it. The art can become a collectible item. And also, art also helps to define your design style in a space. So hopefully my three essential elements, or three essential things that you need to create a luxe look in your space, will give you some great ideas on how to create a luxe look in your home. Okay guys, so hopefully you enjoyed this episode, and please comment below which one of those tips you will be using in your next redesign or remodeling of a space in your home. And if you are not already a subscriber, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button, and don't forget to turn on your alert notification button so that you will be updated or alerted to whenever I upload a new video. And also, if you enjoyed this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. And once again, thanks for watching Designing with Tamala Bowie Interiors. Designing for how you really live in your home. Bye.